Hi and welcome to today's video. Today we will be discussing about the reproduction in Chiara. In case of Chiara, it reproduces by vegetative as well as sexual methods. And there is no means of asexual reproduction in case of Chiara. So first let's move on to the vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction takes place by three means here. First is by amylum stars. Amylum stars are vegetative cells. These are actually star-shaped cells called amylum stars. They develop from the lower nodes and they have rich amount of reserve food materials. As and when they detach from the parent cell, they develop to a new plant. So amylum stars are nothing but star-shaped vegetative cells which on detachment from the parent cell, they grow to a new plant. Second means is through bulbils. Bulbils are small rounded tuber-like structures and these tuber-like structures are called bulbils. They develop on the rhizoids. And these are also bodies which when detached from the parent cell, they develop to a new plant. Third category is secondary protonema. These are the protonemas or they develop from the nodes or from the rhizoids. In both ways they can develop and they develop certain protonema like structures. These protonema like structures they give rise to a new plant. So this is all about vegetative reproduction. So in brief, vegetative reproduction occurs through three ways. First is by amylum stars. Amylum stars are star-shaped vegetative cells. Vegetative cells aggregates. And they when detached from the parent cell, they form a new plant. Bulbils are tuber-like structures which are developed from the rhizoids. And in some species, they may also develop from the stem nodes also. So these tuber-like structures, when they are detached from the parent cell, they can develop to a new plant. Secondary protonemas are developed from the rhizoids or from the nodes of older plants. And these protonema-like structures, they can give rise to a new plant. Coming on to the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction in case of Chiara is oogamous. There are sexual organs, mature sex organs are there which are large and visible. Male sex organs are called as antheridium or globules. This is the male sex organ called as antheridium or globule. The female organ is called as nucule. Nucule or oogonium. Okay. Most of the species are homothallic while some are heterothallic. The position of nucule is always above. As you can see, globule is below and nucule is above. So the position is always like this. Nucule always occupies the upper position and globule is found below the nucule. And they are found on the, they are born on the nodes of short laterals. These are short laterals and these are the nodes. These are the internodes. These are the nodal regions and in between the two nodes, the region between the two nodes is called internode. So, sex organs are born on the nodes of short lateral and take care of the position also. Nucule always is found above and globule is found below the nucule. And coming into the structures, structure of globule or structure of antheridium. It is a large spherical orange-red colored structure and it is attached to the node by means of a stalk. The outermost wall of the globule is composed of 8 large closely arranged shield cells. We call that cells as shield cells and these cells enclose an inner cavity. The center of the shield is attached by means of a rod-shaped cell, elongated cell, and that elongated cell is called manubrium. You can see it in this these are the manubriums. Okay, these four are the manubriums. See here you can see 1, 2, 3, and 4 shield cells. Actually there are 8, which 4 are the on the opposite sides also. So the globule is composed of 8 large shield cells which are curved and closely fitted, and they enclose an inner cavity. This is the inner cavity. Take one shield cell. This shield cell has an elongated cell from the middle portion. So each shield cell has a rod shaped handle like cell from the center, arising from the center, and it extends towards the center of this cavity. That rod like cell is called manubrium. Okay, hope you are clear. So likewise, all the shield cells are having a manubrium. See, this is also having a manubrium, this is also having, this is also having. So here, as we can see, only four, there are only four manubriums visible in this picture. And at the tip of this manubrium, it bears some rounded cells, and that cells are called primary capsula. Okay, so all of these manubrium has at their tip some rounded cells. You can see it here. That rounded cells are called primary capsula, and these primary capsula in turn possess secondary capsula, and each of these secondary capsula bears a pair of branched or unbranched anthridial filaments. That is these filaments. You can see the filaments extending from the center into the cavity. So these are the filaments. So once again, about the structure, globule is a spherical structure which is a orange-red colored structure. It has a pedicel. It is attached to the node through means of a pedicel, and it is composed of 8 large curved shield cells, and each of the shield cell has a manubrium which is arising from the center of the shield cell. This manubrium extends to the interior of the cavity, and at the tip of this manubrium they have primary capsula which are rounded cells. These primary capsula possess yet another cells. They are called secondary capsula, and from these secondary capsula arises certain filaments, and these filaments are called spermatogenous filaments or anthridial filaments. And at the time of maturity, the shield cells move apart. They move apart, exposing the whip-like spermatogenous filaments to the exterior. Each of these filaments possesses up to 100 cells, and they are called androcytes. Each of these androcytes mature to form biflagellate anthrozooids. So at the time of maturity, what happens is these shield cells, which are adjacent shield cells, they move apart, and thus these filaments get exposed. And when they get exposed, after maturity they metamorphosis into biflagellate anthrozooids. That is all about globule. Next is the structure of nucleus. Nucleus, as you can see here, is an elongated structure. It is a macroscopic elongated structure. It has a short stalk also. It is found below the globule. There are 5 spirally twisted tube cells which cover the nucleus except at the top region. 5 tube cells twist around these nucleus, and they cover the nucleus all along except at the top region. And at the top region they form 5 corona cells, and at the time of maturity what happens is they form a slit. They move apart, and a slit is formed here through which anthrozoites can enter into the nucleus and form conduct fertilization. So inside this there are large amount of oil drops and starch grains, and they have rich amount of food materials, and only a single egg is found inside a nucleus. So at the time of fertilization, what happens is a slit is formed here, and the anthrozoites which are liberated from this globules, they swim through water and approach this nucleus, and through the slit they get into the nucleus and fertilize the egg. And after fertilization, coming to the post fertilization process, here what happens is the diploid zygote is formed and it secretes a wall around it. Its own wall is secreted and they become yellow or brown in color. And the oogonium becomes thick and they develop sculpturings also. During germination, the zygote, it settles down at the bottom of the water body. And during germination, the diploid nucleus of the zygote, they undergo meiosis. See, this diploid nucleus undergoes meiosis and four daughter cells are formed. Out of the four nuclei, one migrate to the apical region and three are, they move to the basal region. And a septum is formed to separate this apical cell from the three other cells. The three lower nuclei, they will degenerate. And the outer envelope breaks at the tip of the zygote, exposing the upper cell. See, the upper region, the wall is break down and exposing the apical cell, upper cell. The upper cell then divides by longitudinal division into two cells and they become protonemal cell and rhizoidal cell. Protonemal cell develops to the shoot region and the rhizoidal cell develops to the rhizoids. So thus, a differentiated plant body of Chara is formed. That is all about the germination of zygote. Once again, a zygote is formed after fertilization. Then this zygote, they develop their own separate wall and become yellow and brown in color. The zygote diploid nucleus undergoes meiosis. Four nuclei formed. One is separated to the apical region, three to the basal region, and a wall is develop to separate these, and the outer wall breaks at the tip region, exposing the upper cell, and then the upper nuclei, three nuclei degenerate, and the upper one divide to form two nuclei. That is, one is protonemal initial, and the other is rhizoidal initial. Protonemal initial forms the protonema or the plant body, and rhizoidal initial forms the rhizoids. Thank you.